Yeah, having started two mines myself, one silver, one gold, one in Argentina, one in Japan, China, it's a lot cheaper to buy gold than silver. You know, I didn't have to raise $27 million and then have the Chinese government steal my mine. You know what I mean? Yeah. It's like I could have just bought gold and silver with $27 million, probably worth $50 million today, you know? Yeah. So I like to keep things simple and not think too much. That's why I like God's money. Gold, 79, silver, atomic number, 47. Yeah. It'll be here when the cockroaches are dead. That's all I think about. Okay.
Absolutely. And just finishing it off, of course.
No ETFs. I don't trust anything. Yeah, no paper, gold and silver, you know? Yeah.
Okay. And a very good point to make as we wrap it up. And of course, gold and silver are wealth insurance. So if people are looking at it as a quick investment to make money fast, that's stupid. And you shouldn't do that. You should actually look into why gold and silver have been valuable for so long.
Right. I don't ever sell gold and silver. I just every year, every month I acquire more. And it got to be a big problem because I had to ship it to other countries because I didn't want somebody coming stealing it from me. And I don't keep them in banks. But I never sell. And that drives people crazy. And they go, well, how do you not sell if you buy the stuff? I says, well, I use fiat currency to make money. Yeah. And I use debt. I borrow to buy assets. And they go, well, how do you do that? I said, education. Mm-hmm. You got to practice, you know. I play Monopoly every single day. Mm-hmm. But I use fake money to play Monopoly. And with Monopoly, I buy real money, which is gold and silver.
Mm-hmm. And don't forget,